just want to ask a question about recycling, if I can. Sorry.
Yeah. Can I?
Most of us understand about recently the recycling that that was offered at so many hundreds of dollars a year that they would come around, etc., and put yourself down to it. I've on four occasions sent emails and an idea to the Mareeba Council. And my idea is this. A very innovative idea, first council in the country, possibly the first in the world maybe to do this. And that is, South Australia's had recycling for how many years? 50, 60 years on bottles, cans and milk crates. That what Mareeba Council could do, Kuranda people could take their bottles, cans, etc. to the refuse area, get it weighed, etc. and maybe that money then can come off our council rates. It might be $100 a year. But at least it's going to guarantee that we would be more proactive instead of going down to 15 bins up at the old Kuranda primary school, which are always full, and not being able to fill them up. That maybe then people might be more proactive and go to a facility. Now, the $100 a year is based on what South Australia statistically say. Every person actually gets back in recycling a year. So my suggestion is that a person would collect bottles, cans, milk bottles, etc., take them to them, get a return. That return then would come off as a not money per se, but it would come off the council rates. Just a
thank
thought.
You. The question is, whether we also have a property, have a demo for recyclables down at the waste station down there along the road, spill and process these things and give a credit on your rates. I'm very pleased to be able to tell you about a fellow called Alan Wilson. He's the Deputy Mayor of Cookshire. And Alan is also the Chairman of an organisation called Gourmet. It's a local authority waste advisory committee that involves all councils from McCaidor. And Alan has been arguing the case for a container deposit legislation now for some 5 years. He's been to South Australia, he's been to Switzerland, he's been to Germany, he's had a look at these things, all at his own cost. And he's finally won. The Mareeba, the Queensland government has agreed to the introduction of exactly that. So has now the Northern Territory, and I understand Western Australia. And they will be based on these the South Australian models. So I anticipate that domestic recyclables will go through a different process in the foreseeable future. So because there will be 10 cents paid deposit on each container, and it will be refunded on when it's handed back. It's a complex process, and I don't properly understand it. But what I do know is that it has taken a lot of work. It is a worthy exercise. I'm proud to have been part of it, and I think that will settle much of the question about recycling of drink containers. If you want to know what the Mareeba Shire Council actually does in terms of recycling, and it's not just the 11 bins that are down at the back of the old school site, we recycle waste oil, tyres. We charge for tyres. We charge for gas bottles.
Batteries.
Batteries.
No.
Never? What are we
charged for? Charged for air conditioners, gas bottles, tyres, dead bodies.
That's only fridges that have not been degassed.
Only fridges that have not been degassed, the same as air conditioners. If they've been degassed, and we don't charge for it, it's just metal, and it goes to the metal.
So we recycle metal, waste plastic. Irrigation tubing. We gather together and recycle fertilizer bags. There's no chance for that. They just rolled up the farmers, bring them back, picked up and taken away and recycled. So we are heavily involved in that sort of a process. Green waste is recycled to put into the compost.
Thanks for the recycling bins at the school. I was just a bit curious. In the sort of instructions, it says not to put lids.
Not to what?
Not to put lids in. Does that mean that you take the lid off, wash it, bottle it up?
Sure.
Put
sure.
The lid? Do we take in the bottles separately or not put the lids in at all?
Shouldn't put the lids in at all. It's a different plastic, okay?
Okay. Well, Federation Street takes. Federation Street takes lids in at all.
Yeah. That's just where we are. But it doesn't matter. I mean, it's really big. We would prefer it that way. Okay.
What day are they? What day are they empty?
Every Monday. Not 99% of the time they're every Monday, unless because I'm the one who empties them. So, if I have something on that Monday, I'll either do it the Sunday or the Tuesday. Right. But it's once a week. I guarantee it's once a week.
Yeah. Okay. There's one other thing that I've just been reminded of, and I haven't told you. We are at the moment involved in a regional waste tender process with Kansas City and Douglas Shire. Douglas is involved. And that is for the curbside pickup, and that does include curbside recycling pickup.
Yes.
Now, that's part of the tender. However, depending on the cost of that, that particular component, we'll have to go back to the community and say, hey, wait a minute, this is going to cost you, whatever it is, a fortnight for that pickup service. We would then have a contract with Kansas City because they have a material recycling facility down there on Earth. We don't want to spend several $1 million building a Earth contract with them. They sort of, you've seen, all seen it on television, a fellow that says, no, there's no place like our place, they're skinned that way. They do a magnificent job. So we're going down those tracks all the time. That's part and parcel of what we do on a daily basis. That tender will close reasonably shortly, and it'll be put into place in December of next year.
But then it's an extra cost to us, then, isn't it? Or that's sort of
the reason for the regional waste contract is to minimise the cost to everybody. That's what it is all about. If there's a curbside recycling attached to that, yes, you will pay for that service. It will probably be a fortnight of the service, and it's cost of the pickup itself. That's our plan.